I'm writing a very long and complex Word document, but there are multiple people contributing to it, and I don't want to let them see each other's data. So each one of them contributes the document to me, and I want to create a single combined document. The obvious thought is to copy paste, but don't do that because there is a much better way. That's called master document view. So let's see how that is done. So these are the three documents which three different people are already writing. Go to Word, create a new document. I'm going to give it a title and write the introduction. Apply the title style. This is just a heading or a topic. So apply heading one and let me add some random text. I'm going to save this as a master document. At this stage, I want to refer to or add those three files into this document, but without copy pasting. Go to the View tab and choose Outline View. We rarely use it, but it's a very powerful thing. Click on the button called Show Document. This opens out some extra menu items. Click on the Insert and choose one of those files. I'm going to start with Scope of Work. It may give you some conflict messages for heading styles. Right now, just say no to all. We are in Outline View, but I want to see how the document looks. So I'm going to say Close Outline View. And now, this is the part I wrote, and this part is coming from the other or second document. Let me open the actual document itself and show you the difference. This is a separate file, the same scope of work, but the colors are different, fonts are different. But when it is shown as a part of my master document, it is going to take the appearance of the master document. So it applies the base document styles automatically. At the end of this document, I'm going to add two more. So View, Outline, Show Document, Insert, Team Structure, and Insert Finance Inputs. One document at a time. Close the Outline View. And there we have it. The entire document is now combined. Although it looks like a single document, the content is coming from three different documents. Because I'm going to treat it as a single document, of course I want a header and footer which is uniform across the board. So let's add page numbers. And now even if you go to the last page, you should see the page number. But we are not seeing the page number. Why? This happens because headers are different for each section. And by default, headers are linked to each other. But in this case, for some reason, linking was broken. So click on Link to Previous. Now it'll ask you whether you want to delete whatever is existing. Yes. And now all the three documents are still showing a continuous set of page numbers. And that's exactly what we wanted. While I'm in the master document, I can edit the subdocuments as well. To identify this text later, I'm going to give it red font color. And then open the scope of work document. And the changes from master have reflected here. The reverse is also true. If I make changes here, they will reflect in the master. Changes to documents can be blocked by enabling lock document. I opened the master document again, and you'll notice that after what I had written, you will see only the links to those files. So how do I expand those files? Go to View tab again, Outline, Expand Subdocuments. Now those will expand. You can close the Outline view and look at it as a cohesive document. But I don't want to go and click on Expand Collapse every time. So remember the shortcut. Collapse subdocuments, control backslash, it's a toggle. Collapse, expand. You can treat it as a single file for all practical purposes, and it'll print as expected. I'm sure you found this useful. So what to do next? Try it out. Let me know if you have any queries. Share it with your colleagues and friends. And of course, subscribe, click on the bell icon and like the video. See you next time. Thank you.